Here to replace a draft inducer that's making a lot of noise. The bearings are starting to go out. All right. This is a GMH95 070. Yep. Bearings are shot. So, a lot of moisture in there. I'm going to clean the trap out here too. Been leaking for a minute. Yeah. See, gasket's not bad. This is the motor that I use, or the gasket I pulled out of this motor, so I don't have a new gasket. So, debating if I want to mess with that. Things that make you go, Well, I got some Permatex, so let me yeah, you can see it's been leaking. Looks like it's been leaking up here too, but it's pretty wet down there. So I think I'm gonna pull this off and then put some Permatex around that, and I'll go ahead and put some Permatex around that before I put this new draft inducer on. Not want to get out of there. It is seated. Let's see. Thank you. broke it. Ooh, that was a close call. That was a close call. I thought I broke that. My heart just stopped. Came off easy. These turbulators need to be facing down. See, on the newer designs, we're only like this tall, and these turbulators here are actually down here, and you gotta flip them up. Just put it on liberally. That way it makes a nice seal. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and let that sit up for a minute. Now I'm going to take this gasket here off. There, we got a nice gasket and a nice surface to put that on. This stuff can be super messy if you're not careful, so. Try to get it prepped as best as you can. Yeah, basically one shot. Get a couple screw holes lined up and then you can go to town. There we got a nice gasket going around there now. I'll put a little bit around this as well. All right. So let me there's a little bit of, I don't know if you can see that. There's something in there, like a piece of white. Looks like PVC. That was a piece of silicone or something in that drain that I happened to catch. As far as I know, there's no draining issues with this, but this pressure switch port over here was a little moist, had moisture in it. And the tube too was a little wet. Like I said, she's been having some issues, intermittent issues with this not heating. She's had to reset the breaker a few times. So like I said, I was here last week and kind of babysat it and did any kind of mishaps. I just love those kind of jobs. Oh yeah, this is just nasty. Oh yeah. All sorts of gunk in that drain. One more time. There we go. Three's a charm. Look at this one. That's not too bad. That's clear. Yep, that's nothing in that one. Seems like the most times you have drainage issues, it's coming off the vent drain. Backwards. Cocky in that one. All right, let me put this back up. Alright, let me put this draft inducer back on. Screws started. All right. As you notice how I ran this tube over this one, this is for your collector box pressure switch, and this is for your draft inducer pressure switch. If you put this one over here, this it would have a chance to hit this wheel, so make sure you run it over like that. So just a little tidbit. Well, I believe we're good to go. Clean that flame sensor on here too. Yeah, maybe I could have used a smaller bit. All right. It's a lot quieter. Guys, that's it for this one. Thanks for watching. You know what to do. If you like this kind of content, like and subscribe. Appreciate the support.